Welcome to St James's Church for our Easter Sunday celebration. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. It's lovely to be with you this Easter Sunday. And a big thank you to Natasha Evans, who sent in this photo on the screen, picturing the north door of St James's Church and beyond the Tree of Hope in full blossom, ready for Easter, and then that amazing sunset. We have much to celebrate and give thanks for this day. So let's begin our worship with an Easter poem by Christy Brink. A sinless saviour, falsely accused, tried as a criminal, beaten, abused. The shouts from the crowd ring in his ear, crucify him, mocks and jeers, heartache and pain, sorrow and tears. He accepts his sentence and carries his cross, walking down streets that are lined with the lost. The sound of the hammer, blood falls to the ground, pain on his forehead from thorns turned to a crown. Jesus looks to the heavens, but hangs on a tree, nail-pierced hands surrounded by thieves. To those so unworthy, he offers forgiveness, then breathes his last breath and cries out, "It is finished." And then darkness and silence and void, and the world holds its breath, and angels wait in expectation. Darkness fills the earth, a quiet void and all creation, a confused and desperate nation. And for 3 long days, Satan thinks he's won, but that lie has come undone with the rising of our sun, for our mighty God has won. For he's alive, he rose to life, an empty tomb, a brilliant light. He rose again, our risen Lamb. He rose again, fulfilled the plan. He took the sins of every man and led his son to victory, released the chains, set captives free. He rose again for you and me. No kingdom can stand against him. No power can overcome him. Death cannot defeat him. But all the world will bow before him, for he's our King, our God eternal, living water, sweet Emmanuel, our King of kings, all in all, Prince of Peace, before him fall. We fall before your majesty, O precious Lord, we worship thee. He's our redemption, our forgiveness, the hope of every man. By his wounds we have been healed, for this was the Father's plan. And now Christ sits upon his throne, in justice, peace and truth. The curtain has been torn, sweet communion now with you. Praise and glory all to you. I was nothing but a sinner, I should have been guilty. Yet you loved me through it all and took the punishment for me. Hallelujah, you have saved me. Hallelujah, you took my place. Hallelujah, I'm set free.
See you.
such an amazing Easter praise song. So together, let's stand firm on our foundation and declare our statement of faith together. Christ died for our sins in accordance with the scriptures. He was buried. He was raised to life on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. Afterwards, he appeared to his followers and all the apostles. This we have received and this we believe. Amen.
Sing with me, "And Can It Be?"
And can it be that I I rose with hope.
as we've just declared in that last hymn, no condemnation now I dread. Jesus and all in him is mine. Alive in him, my living head, and clothed in righteousness divine, bold I approach the eternal throne and claim my crown through Christ my own. We know that we don't always live up to God's standards. We don't always follow his ways. So we gather together in this time of confession. Loving God, we confess that at times we do not share in the joy of the resurrection, but are caught in the worries of the world. We confess that we do not always live in the spirit of new life, but remain discontent, grumbling, and anxious. Forgive us when we find it more comfortable to worry and complain than to risk the joy and encouragement of new life in Christ. Call us back to your ways, O God, to seek hope and reconciliation, restoration and peace. In the name of the risen Christ, we pray. Amen. Christ is risen, the stone is rolled away, the tomb found empty. Mary calls out, I have seen the Lord. We have seen the Christ too, in every helping hand, in every heartfelt gift, in every choice to restore life in this world. We are called to this new life, a life of forgiveness and reconciliation. Lord, thank you that you forgive us. Please help us to accept your forgiveness and know your love each day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for your love and your forgiveness, time and again, year after year. Your mercies are new every morning. It was the first day of the week. It was evening, but not any ordinary evening. It was the evening of the morning that Peter and I found Jesus's tomb empty. To be fair, it was some of the women in our group who found it first. They raced back to tell us, and we raced off in the opposite direction. His body was gone. There was no doubt. So how do you think we felt, Peter and I? And what do you think we imagined had happened to our friend? It was the first day of the week. It was evening. And we were hidden away in a room, the door locked tight. For we were afraid that the very people who had put Jesus to death would eventually come for us. But that's not who came that evening. No. Even if they had planned to surprise us, to catch us unawares, no surprise could complete with the surprising thing that actually happened. For while we were huddled there, Jesus arrived. That's right, Jesus. What do you think went through our heads? What questions? What thoughts? Peace be with you. That's what he said. Shalom. An ordinary everyday greeting. But there was nothing ordinary about this day. Was he a ghost? Were we imagining things? But when he showed us his hands and his side, we knew it was him. And I can't even begin to describe the joy we felt. Then he repeated his greeting, peace be with you, and gave us a job to do. Just like my Father sent me, he said, so I'm sending you. And then he breathed on us. What do you think that felt like? After he said, receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive anyone, they are forgiven. And if you hold back your forgiveness, they are not. What do you think he meant by that? And with that, he left. We couldn't stop talking about what happened, and then Thomas knocked on the door. He was one of our group, one of Jesus' disciples, and he had a twin brother, so that's what we called him, the twin. All right, it's not that creative, but it stuck. Anyway, as soon as we had unlocked the door and let him in, we told him about Jesus' surprise visit, how we'd seen his hands and his side, how he'd given us the Holy Spirit, well, everything really, all at once, like people do when they're excited. Now, if someone told you that your friend who was dead was now alive, what would you say? How would you react? Not Thomas. Nope. Unless I see those nail marks in his hands with my own eyes, he said. And unless I put my finger in those marks and my own hand in his side, I will not believe that Jesus is alive. He didn't believe us, obviously. Maybe you have some idea why. Anyway, a week later, we were back in that room, all of us, Thomas included. The door was shut, just the same as before. And then suddenly, once again, there was Jesus. How do you think we felt? Shalom, he said again. Peace be with you. Then right away he turned to Thomas. Put your finger here, he said. Look at my hands. Now take your own hand and put it in my side. Stop your doubting. Believe. And what do you think Thomas did? He believed all right. My Lord and my God, was all he could say. And that just about said it all. But Jesus wasn't finished. You have seen me and you have believed, he said. Blessed are the ones who believe, even though they have not seen. Which is more or less why I have written this book that you are reading. When he was with us, Jesus did lots of other amazing things to show us exactly who he was. Too many things to include in this book. But the things I have included are there so that you might believe. Believe like Thomas eventually did, that Jesus is the Messiah, God's Son. And that, believing, you might find life in his name. our prayers will be a little bit different today. I'm inviting you to pray in a physical prayer. We are each mind, body and spirit, a beautiful whole. So we can pray using our bodies as well as our minds and our words. If possible, let's stand together. And if you want to, you could take off your shoes to really feel the ground under your feet. Move your weight from toes to heel a couple of times and then settle. We're using John chapter 20 when Jesus appears to his disciples after the resurrection. So close your fists and cross your arms in front of you if you can. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the disciples were together, with the doors locked for the fear of the Jewish people. Many of us carry fears or put up barriers around ourselves, just like the disciples did. Christian life can make us feel vulnerable, and it's easy to get caught up in worry or anxiety. So as you clench your fists, and keep that barrier of arms in front of you. Spend a moment to bring before God those things that worry you. Let God know what you fear at this time. The story continues. Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Release your arms, release your fists, and relax your hands. Jesus says, "Peace be with you." The disciples were still in their locked room, and we are still in the same circumstances. But Jesus says, "Peace be with you." The text goes on. After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples were overjoyed when they saw the Lord. Press your fingers into your hands to remind yourself of Jesus' physical wounds, scars that speak of victory over death and evil. The disciples were overjoyed when they saw the Lord. What aspect of salvation are you thankful, even overjoyed about today? Victory over death, freedom from the oppression of sin, rebuilt relationships with God and others, the grace of forgiveness, the presence of God in your life. As you bring your thankfulness and joy to God, stretch out your arms wide in praise. Next, the passage says, again Jesus said, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you." And with that he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit." Jesus breathed on them and gave the Holy Spirit. Imagine Jesus breathing on you and take a big inhale. Breathe in peace. And breathe out fear. Breathe in God's presence with you. Breathe out worry. Breathe in, breathe out. And together let's pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and for ever. Amen. Lord God, you loved this world so much that you gave your one and only Son, that we might be called your children too. Lord, help us to live in the gladness and grace of Easter Sunday, every day. Let us have hearts of thankfulness for your sacrifice. Let us have eyes that look upon your grace and rejoice in our salvation. Help us to walk in that mighty grace and tell your good news to the world, all for your glory. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us now and remain with us evermore. Amen.